Elmo's back!
Dorothy. Oh, hi. Welcome to Elmo's world. Elmo's so happy to see you. Oh, and so is Dorothy. Say hello, Dorothy. Guess what Elmo's thinking about today? Door. A little help. Come on, Door. One second, please.
Something. That's a car.
Think of something in the sky, Mr. Noodle.
They're not in the sky. Cars are on the ground.
Yeah, see, that's the ground.
Keep trying.
That's a surfboard.
A surfboard? No way.
Hang ten, Mr. Noodle. Wow, that looks like fun.
What is something in the sky?
Surfboards are in the water, not in the sky.
Try to think of something you see when you look up in the sky.
A kite?
Oh. A kite. Yeah, a kite's in the sky.
Oh, but it's not in the sky now.
Throw it up and run, Mr. Noodle. Throw the kite in the air.
You can do it, Mr. Noodle. Almost.
You need the wind to fly the kite.
You need wind like this. Now fly the kite. Wow, that's windy. Now fly the kite.
There it goes.
Yay, Mr. Noodle. Strong.
Now Mr. Noodle's up in the sky, too.
Hold on, Mr. Noodle.
Thanks, Shade. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. What do you see when you look up in the sky?
Hi, Dorothy. This is a picture I made. I made
a sky and a sun. I made the sun yellow, and when I look up at the sun, it's like a golden yellowish. And I mix some blue for the sky because that's how the sky looks sometimes.
Hi, Dorothy. This is a picture of a plane, and it's in the sky really high. And there's a sun, and there's clouds. Do you like it?
Hi, Dorothy. This is a picture that I drew. There's a shooting star, another star, and these are all planets. They're in the sky at night. What do you think?
Oh, thanks, everybody. Oh, thanks, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Oh, hello, baby. Hello. Baby, what do you see when you look up in the sky? Oh, a bird! Oh, thank you, baby. Bye. Oh, boy. And now...
Elmo has mail.
Elmo has mail. That's better. Oh, no. And a computer mouse doesn't fly in the sky either. Thanks, mouse. Let's see who sent Elmo an email. Oh, it's from Humphrey and Ingrid. Hello, Elmo.
Yes, and let me be the first to say, hello, Elmo.
You know, there's something else that you can see when you look up in the sky.
Yes, something near and dear
to our furry little hearts.
Yeah. Look, what? Up in the sky.
Is it a diaper?
Is it a blankie?
No, it's Super Baby. Flying high in the sky. Hello there, you little super cookie. Isn't she the cutest thing you've ever seen?
In the sky? Goodbye, Elmo.
And might I add, goodbye, Elmo.
Thanks, Humphrey and Ingrid. Thanks, computer helicopter. And now, has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many birds are flying in the sky? Let's count them and see.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12.
Oh, 12. 12 birds flying in the sky. Oh, and a kangaroo. Well, wait a minute. Kangaroos can't fly in the sky. Oh. Oh. But they sure do bounce. Oh, silly kangaroo. That makes Elmo wonder. What else can you see when you look up in the sky? Oh, maybe the drawer knows. Drawer. Hello. Oh, there you are. Come on, open up, drawer. Oh, come on, don't be shy. Please open up. Oh, that's it. A little more. A little more. Oh. What can you see when you look up in the sky? A cloud, an elephant, or a mailbox?
A cloud.
Yeah, a cloud. Now, what else? A birthday cake, a rocket, or a bunny rabbit?
A rocket.
Right, a rocket. What about a turtle, a rock, or a worm?
None of them are in the sky.
They're all on the ground.
Unless the worm is slimy, flying in his airplane.
Go, Slimy.
Yay, Slimy. Oh, look! Mr. Noodle is still up in the sky. Oh, hang in there, Mr. Noodle. Fred? Fred, Fred! Boy, you can see some amazing things when you look up in the sky. Elmo's friend, Sherlyn, likes to look up in the sky with her mommy, and she told Elmo all about it. The other day, Sherlyn and her mommy went outside to look up in the sky. It was great. They saw birds. Airplanes. Wow. A blimp. The sun. And lots of kites. Wow, the kites were pretty. But while they were looking up in the sky, they almost got wet. They also saw clouds. Clouds are Cheryl's favorite. If you use your imagination, clouds can look like all sorts of things. Cheryl thought that one looked like a face. And she thought that would look like a cauliflower. And at the end of the day, when the sun went down, they watched it together. It was really pretty. That was when they knew it was almost time for bed. So they went back home. Bye-bye, Shirley and her mommy. Wow. There's lots of pretty things to see when you look up in the sky. But Elmo wants to know more about the sky, don't you? How can we find out more? Oh, yeah, we can watch the Sky Channel. Thank you, TV. Turn yourself on.
Welcome to the Sky Channel, your eye in the sky.
And now for your in-flight entertainment, the little penguin who tried to fly in the sky.
Once upon a time, there was a little penguin who tried to fly in the sky like other birds. He flapped his wings, but that didn't work. He jumped in the air, but that didn't work. He even tried getting a running start. That didn't work either. His little penguin body wasn't made to get off the ground. That's penguin for I'm going to fly if it's the last thing I do. Which is penguin for you're full of hot air. Eureka! He was flying in the sky in a hot air balloon. He was full of hot air. Soon, all the other penguins took to the sky, too. They flew in airplanes, in helicopters, in blimps, even hang gliders. Anything that was made to fly in the sky. And the little penguin lived happily ever after. In the sky, of course. That's penguin for the sky's the limit. The end.
Coming up next on the Sky Channel,
the sky who loved me.
Wait, TV. Elmo still wants to learn more about the sky. Well, how can we find out more?
Maybe I can shed some light on the subject.
Wow! It's the sun! Oh, the sun is bright!
I sure am. I am the brightest thing you will see in the sky. I shine and light everything up.
Boy, the sun does a great job, too.
Thank you. And when I set, it gets dark. It becomes night, and you can't see me anymore.
But you can see me, the moon.
See the moon in the sky at night.
Thanks, Elmo. Sometimes you can even see me in the daytime sky.
That's right.
Oh, yeah. The moon looks pretty in the sky, day or night.
Oh, go on.
Look. Dorothy's imagining the moon in the sky and Elmo's on it. Elmo's gonna dance on the moon.
Sometimes you can see a rainbow in the sky, but only during the day.
Comfy.
At night, if you look up in the sky, you might also see stars. And sometimes a group of stars can make a picture called a constellation. You just have to connect the dots.
Yeah, Elmo's a constellation. Oh, thank you, Dorothy. Oh, and thank you, Sun and Moon.
No sweat.
Boy, Elmo loves the sky. Oh, and so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the sky song.
Hey, can we sing too?
Oh, sure. And you can sing along with us. Here we go. Do-do-do. Sky, 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 sky. Everybody!
Sky, 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 sky.
Say goodbye, Dorothy. Say goodbye, everybody.
Good day.
And good night.
That's Elmo's world.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Elmo loves you.
Have a good night.
Bye.
Bye.
La 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 la, la 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 la, Elmo's world. La 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 la, la 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 la, Elmo's world. Elmo loves his goldfish, his crayon too.
Mr. Noodle, get a raincoat.
You don't wear that when it's raining.
You need a raincoat for the rain and a rain hat.
Try again, Mr. Noodle.
Mr. Noodle?
That's a winter coat and a sled.
What do you wear in the rain? To keep dry, Mr. Noodle.
What's he going to do with the sled?
You don't use a sled in the rain. Sleds are for the snow, not the rain.
Oh, Mr. Noodle, you forgot your sled.
Yay, you did it!
Good job, Mr. Noodle.
You wear a raincoat and boots.
Now open the umbrella.
You're still getting wet. Come on, Mr. Noodle.
You have to open it, Mr. Noodle. Upside down.
Mr. Noodle. Not like that. Hold the handle. Yeah, like that.
Yay, Mr. Noodle.
What's he doing?
Can dance.
Oh, very nice, Mr. Noodle. That Mr. Noodle, he's all wet. What's that? What's that? Say that again, Dorothy. Oh, okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. What do you wear when it rains?
Hi, Dorothy. This is what I wear in the rain, my rain poncho.
Hi, Dorothy. This is what I wear when it rains. My raincoat, my boots, and my umbrella keeps me dry.
This is what I wear when it rains, Dorothy. My raincoat, my rain hat, and my boots, so I can keep my feet dry. Then I can jump in pose like this.
Thanks, everybody. Oh, and thanks, Dorothy. Now, Emma will ask a baby. Hello, baby. What do you wear when it rains? Oh, thank you, baby. Uh-oh. It's raining again. Elmo loves to wear his umbrella hat when it rains. Oh, no. It stopped raining. Oh, well. So
Elmo
now...
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Email. Elmo wants his email. Elmo computer. Has computer. Elmo has mail. Hey, wait a minute. Elmo doesn't have mail. To run.
Elmo has mail.
Stop, computer.
Elmo has
stop.
Mail. Elmo has mail.
Good. Oh, it's Elmo's friend Oscar who sent Elmo email.
You want to know what grouches like to wear in the rain? Nothing! Ha ha! I like to get wet and soggy. I like everything in my trash can to get wet and soggy. That's why I keep the lid up. Oh, and elephants like the rain, too. They like to splash in the puddles. Oh, this is a beautiful day. Now, scram. Wait a minute. I'm sending this email. I'll scram.
Thanks for the message, computer. Door. And now, Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many leaves are blowing in the wind? Let's count them and see.
Oh, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14.
Oh. 14 leaves blowing in the wind. Oh, in one umbrella hat. Oh, boy. Boy, that really blew Elmo away. Great counting, everybody. Now, Elmo wants to learn more about other kinds of weather. Oh, boy. Like snow. Elmo knows you can get cold in the snow, but Elmo wants to know more about snow, don't you? Let's find out. Oh, boy, sounds like there's a snowstorm in Troy. How's the weather in there? Can you swim in the snow?
No.
But you can play in the snow. Can you make a birthday cake out of snow?
Yes, for a snowman.
Happy birthday, snowman. Can you count snow?
No.
Of course you can. You can count the falling snowflakes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, it's a winter wonderland of counting.
Thanks, Julia. Elmo's friend Alex knows a lot of different things you can do in the snow, and he told Elmo all about it.
I woke up in the morning, and it had snowed. It's great in the winter when it snows. Everything was covered with snow. My mom helped me put on my snowsuit because it was cold outside. I fastened up my snow boot and we ran outside. There's so many things you can do in the snow. We made footprints. Animals make footprints too. I made a snow angel. The snow was cold. After that, my mom and I made a snowman. I put on his nose. We also had a snow fight. It was fun. Then we went sledding. I put on my helmet. I slid down the hill really fast. I didn't get too far. I tried again, and again. And again. Sledding is great.
Yeah!
By the end of the afternoon, I got tired. Then we went home, and Mom made hot chocolate. I love hot chocolate, and I love the snow.
Elmo loves the snow, too. Oh, thanks, Alex. Ooh, but Elmo still wants to learn more, don't you? How can we find out more? TV. Oh, yeah. We can watch the Weather Channel. Oh, turn yourself on, TV.
The Weather Channel, blowing into your home. And now, the Weather Lady and the Four Seasons.
Hello, I'm the Weather Lady, and this is my dog, Sunny Boy. We both love the weather. All kinds.
Woof, woof, woof.
He's not just a fair weather friend.
Woof.
We love the seasons, too. All four of them.
Woof, 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 woof.
Take summer. The weather outside is hot and sunny. And sometimes it gets too hot in the summer to do anything except swim. Ooh, they don't call them dog days for nothing. After summer, autumn comes. It gets colder and windy. The leaves turn beautiful colors. And then they fall off the trees. Hey, that's what autumn is sometimes called. Fall. Leaf it to Sunny Boy. Then it gets even colder and winter sets in. Sometimes it snows. Doesn't it, Sunny Boy? Then it starts to get warmer and the snow melts. And it's spring. Not too hot, not too cold. Just a little wet. It rains so flowers and plants can grow. Sometimes it rains so hard, even the weather lady has to go inside. Yes, you too, Sunny Boy. I love the weather. Whether it's summer or fall, winter or spring, and so does Sunny Boy. That's right, Dan.
Coming up on the Weather Channel, a snowman for all seasons.
Catch it before it melts.
Thanks, TV. But Elmo wants to learn even more about weather, don't you? How can we find out even more? Who could that be? Whoa! Whoa!
Wanna talk to a tornado? I'm a storm with lots of strong wind.
Elmo can see that. But tornado's too windy. So tornado has to go. Go, go, go. Go, 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 go. Go, tornado. Go.
You can't play outside when I'm around.
Boy, tornado's not kidding.
But most of the time, you can have a little fun in the weather.
Oh, really?
Sure. You can even play sports.
What sports?
Depends on the weather. If it's a nice windy day, it's great to go wind surfing.
Oh, no! Dorothy's imagining Elmo wind surfing!
When there's snow, it's great to go skiing. You're welcome. Let's twist again sometime.
Okay, bye-bye. Woo! Oh, Elmo loves weather. Oh, and so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the weather song. Here we go. Do-do-do, do-do-do-do-do. Weather, 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 weather.
Just passing by. I'm on my way to the doctor for a checkup.
Oh, okay.
See you later.
Bye, Big Bird.
Bye.
That's what Elmo's thinking about today. Doctors. Oh, is there a doctor in the house?
Did someone call Dr. Zero to
I don't know what I
You know, doctors. Wait a minute. That's not a doctor. That's a doctor. And a quack. Do with a stethoscope. telescope? Oh, good question, Dorothy. Let's ask Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle! Oh, up shade, please. Thank you. Mr. Noodle. Hi, Mr. Noodle. Hi. Mr. Noodle, Dorothy has a question. Oh, what does a doctor do with a stethoscope, Mr. Noodle?
Yeah, Mr. Noodle. What does a doctor do with it?
Look at that!
He's got a doctor's coat on.
Nice.
Mr. Dr. Noodle!
Wait, what's that in his pocket?
Oh, look! That's a stethoscope!
Now he's got it. A stethoscope. So do your thing, Mr. Noodle. Yeah, what does a doctor do with it?
What's the last?
A dog? What's he gonna do with that dog?
What's he up to?
That's not where it goes.
No, you use a leash to walk a dog, not a stethoscope.
Mr. Noodle, you don't put it on the dog. You put it on you.
Yeah, put the stethoscope on you. Yeah, I have a dog like that.
That's nice, Mr. Noodle.
Oops. He's okay.
Go ahead. Put the stethoscope on, Mr. Noodle.
Wait, now what's he doing? It's not a tail, Mr. Noodle.
The stethoscope goes in your ears, Mr. Noodle.
Put it in your ears.
Yeah, your ears.
Right, up there. Your ears. Good job. Now he's got it.
The stethoscope helps you hear better.
Ooh, be careful. A doctor uses it to listen to the heart. Whose heart are you gonna listen to, Mr. Noodle? So find somebody.
Mr. Noodle's looking around.
Will he find someone? He's on the move.
Oh, Mr. Noodle can listen to Elmo's heart. Go ahead, Mr. Noodle.
No, not there.
No, that's not where Elmo's heart is. It's here, in Elmo's chest. Go ahead, Mr. Noodle.
Right there.
Oh, that's cold.
Oh, he's warming it up. Nice, Mr. Noodle.
Better.
Good job, Mr. Noodle. Sounds good.
Oh, yay! You did it! Way to go, Mr. Noodle!
Now what?
Oh, yeah! Listen to your own heart.
He found his heartbeat.
Wow! Mr. Noodle's heart is beating with a rhythm.
He's doing his thing. Ba-boom, ba-boom, ba-doo-doo-doo. He's got the beat. I like the way Mr. Noodle dances.
Me too.
Mr. Noodle has a lot of heart and soul. What's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. What does a doctor do with a stethoscope?
Dorothy, a doctor listens to your heartbeat with a stethoscope like this. Ba-boom, ba-boom, ba-boom.
And a doctor also uses it to listen to your lungs. Breathe deep, breathe deep, breathe deep. Sounds great.
Oh, thanks, everybody. Oh, and thank you, Dorothy. Now, Emma will listen to a baby's heartbeat. Hi, Sienna. Sienna, where's your heart? Oh, there it is. Okay, okay. Oh, yeah. Wow. Boy, you have a really good heartbeat. Oh, thank you, baby. Boy, you gotta have heart. Oh, and now Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many stethoscopes are dancing in this conga line? Let's count them together and find out.
One, two, three, four, five, six,
The doctor's office in the waiting room. I'm waiting to see the doctor. Hey, gee. I guess that's why they call this the waiting room. I like waiting because there's so many great toys in this waiting room. Like this doctor kit. Okay, Radar. Now I'm Dr. Big Bird, and I'm going to examine you now. First, I'll look in your ear. Uh-huh. Fuzzy, just like they should be.
Big Bird, the doctor will see you now.
The doctor? Oh, the doctor. Gotta go. Bye, Elmo.
Oh, thanks, computer. Boy, that makes Elmo wonder. Who else goes to the doctor? I could say Elmo met Doctor, the doctor. Who goes to the doctor and who doesn't? Let's find out. Oh, drawer, open up, please. Oh, come on, drawer. Like the doctor says, open up and say, ah! Do birthday cakes go to the doctor?
No.
But a doctor can have a birthday. Does a baby go to the doctor?
Yes.
A baby doctor?
No.
Not a baby who is a doctor. A doctor for babies and kids. A pediatrician.
Oh, a pediatrician. Do elephants go to the doctor?
Not like that.
In a zoo, the animal doctor comes to an elephant.
Does a rock go to the doctor?
No, rocks don't go to doctors.
Unless it's my pet rock, Rocco. Say ah, Rocco.
It's a rock, Zoe. Ah, thanks, Troy. Elmo's friend Joe went to the doctor for a checkup. And he told Elmo all about it. You want to watch too, Troy? Okay.
Once a year, I go to the doctor for a checkup. Just to make sure I'm healthy. My mom always comes with me. Uh-oh. First, the nurse weighed me. Nurses help doctors.
Good.
Then she measured me.
Turn around.
I grew 2 inches last year. Then the doctor came in. She asked me to take off my shirt so she could examine me. First, she listened to my heart with a stethoscope. Then she listened to my lungs. Didn't hurt, but it was a little cold. Then she looked in my ears. That didn't hurt, but it tickled a little bit. She used something called a tongue depressor to look at my throat. The doctor said to stick up my tongue and say, ah. Ah. That didn't hurt either. Then the doctor examined the rest of me. My eyes. My stomach. My knees. None of that hurt either. She said I was very healthy. But I needed a shot so I would stay healthy. That hurt, but only for a minute. And then I got to pick out a sticker. And the exam was over. Mom said she was really proud of me. I was proud of me, too.
Aw, Elmo's so proud of Joe, too. Now, Elmo wants to learn more about doctors. How can Elmo find out more? Is TV? Is TV sick? Does TV need a doctor?
No.
Oh, Elmo gets it. We can watch the doctor's channel. Turn yourself on, TV.
You're watching the doctor's channel. Just what the doctor ordered. And now, here's Doc Martin. Give it to us straight, Doc.
Hi, Doc Martin here with some doctorly advice. Hit it!
You're asking me, Doc, how do I stay strong? Just do the doctor all day long.
Do the doctor.
Do the doctor with me. Open your mouth and you won't feel blah. Stick out your tongue and just say ah.
Ah.
Next on the Doctor's Channel, Dr. No, followed by Dr. Yes.
Thanks, TV! Elmo wants to know even
hi,
more.
Hi, Elmo.
Oh, hi, Big Bird.
Hi, I'm back from my checkup.
Oh, how did it go, Big Bird?
Well, the doctor says I'm fine and feathered.
Oh, good!
Bye, Elmo.
Bye, Big Bird. Elmo still wants to find out more about doctors. Oh, no. Sorry. Elmo meant doctors. Doctors. Sorry. How can we find out more? Even more? Oh, excuse Elmo.
Want to talk to a doctor?
Oh, sure. What's up, Doc?
Well, for one thing, there are lots of different kinds of doctors.
Really?
Okay, doctors, the monster will see you now. Oh, yes, there they come.
Okay. Hey. I'm an eye doctor.
I am a foot doctor.
What kind of doctor are you?
He's not a doctor. He's a monkey.
Hey, I'd like a second opinion.
You're a monkey.
Aw, he's my patient. I'm an animal doctor, a veterinarian.
Oh, yeah, even animals have doctors.
That's right. Dogs, cats, giraffes, whales.
Whoa, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a veterinarian underwater. Okay, time for your checkup. Open wide and say,
that goldfish has a whale of an imagination.
She sure does. Boy, doctors are great. Oh, Dorothy thinks so, too. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the doctor song.
Ooh, may we sing along, too?
Sure.
Oh.
Doctors. Sing along. happy to see you. Oh, and so is Dorothy. Say hello, Dorothy. Guess what I'm most thinking about today? Wow. Look at it. Beautiful. Oh, yeah, bicycles. You know, bicycles. Too. Oh, and Dorothy has a question. What is it, Dorothy? Oh, okay. How do you ride a bike? Oh, very good question, Dorothy. Oh, let's ask Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle! Oh, nice digging, Shay. Now go up, please. Oh, stay up, Shay. Come on, Shay. Stay up. Stay up, please. Oh, thank you. Oh, look! That's Mr. Noodle's brother, Mr. Noodle! Hi, Mr. Noodle! Mr. Noodle! Mr. Noodle! Oh, Mr. Noodle, Dorothy has a question for you! Is Mr. Noodle ready for Dorothy's question now? Oh, good.
How do you ride a bicycle, Mr. Noodle?
A bicycle!
You'll need the helmet.
A helmet protects your head.
Very good, Mr. Noodle. You have to wear a helmet when you ride a bike.
But you need a bicycle.
Go get a bicycle, Mr. Noodle.
Mr. Noodle!
That's for little kids.
You're too big.
No, that's too small for you. That's a tricycle, not a bicycle.
You need a bicycle. A bicycle.
A two-wheeler.
That's better.
That's the right size bicycle.
Now, how do you ride it?
Get on a bike.
No.
Turn around, Mr. Noodle.
Not the bike. Turn yourself around.
You need to turn yourself around and face the other way on the bicycle.
Yeah, like that.
Mr. Noodle, come on. No, no, ride the bike. No. Mr. Noodle! No!
Put your feet on the pedals and push.
That's the pedals.
Now push.
One foot on?
Now put your other foot on the pedal.
And the other foot, Mr. Noodle. You can do it.
He's doing it.
Yeah, now pedal. Keep pedaling.
He's a little shaky.
Yay! That's great, Mr. Noodle.
Stop, Mr. Noodle.
You can stop now, Mr. Noodle.
He can't stop.
Does Mr. Noodle know how to stop?
Stop.
Uh-oh.
Are you okay, Mr. Noodle?
I think the bike is broken.
Well, he almost had it. What's that, Dorothy? Okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you ride a bike?
Dorothy, this is how I ride a tricycle. I pedal with my feet.
Dorothy, this is how you ride a bike with training wheels. Dorothy, this is how I ride my bike. Since I don't have any training wheels, I have to balance on my bike.
Thanks, Dorothy. Oh, thanks, kids. And now, Elmo will ask a baby. Oh, hi, baby. Baby, how do you ride a bike? Oh, wow, look!
Elmo, what are you doing?
Elmo's watching you! Thank you, baby! And now, Elmo has a question for you! How many wheels are on this tricycle? Let's count them and see. Here we go.
One.
Two.
Three.
Okay, now how many wheels are on a bicycle with training wheels? Let's count them and see. Here we go.
One. Two. Three. Four.
Okay, and how many wheels are on a bicycle without training wheels? Well, four wheels take away two wheels, leaves
one. Two.
Two wheels, yay! Great counting, everybody! Oh, bye, tricycle, bye, bicycle, bye, training wheels. Tricycles and bicycles have wheels. That makes Elmo wonder. What else has wheels? Elmo wants to know, don't you? Let's find out. Okay, open up, drawer.
No.
Oh, please, drawer, open up.
No.
Well, Elmo's just gonna have to open it. Do horses have wheels?
No.
Do ice cream cones have wheels?
No.
But you can get an ice cream cone from the ice cream truck. It has wheels. Does Zoe have wheels?
No.
She does if she's in her Zoe-mobile.
See you later.
Thanks, drawer. And now...
Elmo has mail.
Oh, good. Elmo has email. Oh, look. Elmo's got email from his friend Super Grover. Yay!
Oh, hi, Elmo. It is I, your cute, furry little super pal, Super Grover. And I am riding here on my cute little super bicycle. Ha, ha, ha. It takes a lot of practice to ride a super bicycle. Oh, yeah. Whoops. Ah! I guess I still need some more practice. So does the bicycle. Bye, Elmo.
Bye, Super Grover. Bye, computer. Thank you. Wow. Super Grover really has to practice to ride a super bicycle. Elmo's friend Tyler knows all about practicing. He had to practice riding his bicycle after he took off his training wheels. And he told Elmo all about it.
All my friends could ride their bikes without training wheels. And I wanted my training wheels off too. So my mom took them off for me. I tried riding, but it felt different without my training wheels. I almost fell, but my mom was holding the bike, so I didn't. I guess I got scared. I wanted to put the training wheels back on, but my mom said I just needed to practice, and she would be right there. So I practiced riding, and my mom held the handlebars in the back seat. And I practiced, and practiced, and practiced, and I got better and better. My mom let go of the handlebars, and I kept going. Then she let go of the back seat. I got scared and fell off. It didn't hurt, so I got back on. My mom held the back of the seat again, but not for long. she let go, I kept going. Now I ride my bike with my friends without my training wheel. It's fun.
Tanner did great, didn't he? It sure helps to practice. But now Elmo wants to know more about bicycles, don't you? How can we find out more? Oh, yeah, that's right. We can watch the Bicycle Channel. Oh, good. Turn yourself on, TV.
The Bicycle Channel. All bicycles all the time. Ride on. And now, our spokesperson.
Hello there, bicycle fans. Guess what? I love bicycles. You know why? Because they're fun. Fun to ride. Whee! Fun to go places on. Whoopee! Fun to exercise on. Feeling the burn. They're even fun to sing about. Hey, let's sing a song about a bike now. You may know this song already about a bus. I changed it to a bike because I love bikes. You ready? The wheels on the bike go round and round, round and round, round and round. The wheels on the bike go round and round all through the town. The bell on the bike goes ding, 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 ding. The bell on the bike goes ding, ding, ding all through the town. The handlebars on the bike go turn, 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 turn. The handlebars on the bike go turn, turn, turn all through the town. The person on the bike goes up and down, up and down, up and down. The person on the bike goes up and down all through the town. That was great. And now I'm gonna ride my bike all through the town. See you next time.
Coming up next on the Bicycle Channel, the Dick Van Bike Show.
Don't you? How can we find out more? Who could that be? Let's find out.
You want to talk to a bicycle?
Yeah, we could talk to a bicycle.
Not without me.
Oh, and a helmet.
I go everywhere bicycle goes. I protect your head. You never get on a bike without me.
Oh, well, I'm going to remember that. Good. Helmet. Thanks, helmet. Good. Oh, now it's your turn, bicycle.
Oh, funny you should mention turn. See, you can turn me with my handlebars, see?
Oh. Oh, nice. Neat.
You can also pedal my pedals here and make me go slowly.
Oh, she's going slow.
That's slow.
Or fast.
Fast, very fast.
That's fast.
Fast is great if you want to be in a bicycle race.
Oh, you can race on a bicycle?
Sure.
Not without me.
Oh, look, look, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo in a bicycle race. Yay! Elmo just won the Tour de Chance. Yay!
You can also deliver newspapers on a bicycle.
Not without me.
Good morning, sir. Here's your newspaper. Thank you.
You can also ride a unicycle. Unicycles are great for riding in the circus and doing tricks.
Not without me.
One, two, three. Huh?
Pleasure. Well, I gotta be pedaling along.
Not without me.
Bye, Elmo.
Oh, bye. Bye-bye. Elmo really loves bicycles. Oh, and so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the bicycle song. Yay! Oh, here we go.
Bicycle,
bicycle, bicycle, bicycle, bicycle. up a ride?
Not without me.
Elmo loves you.
Bye-bye.
La, 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 Elmo's world. La, 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 Elmo's world. Elmo loves his goldfish, his crayon too.
It's a letter.
You don't dunk a letter.
That's not how you mail a letter. That's how you play basketball.
Try again.
Hey, where'd the basket go?
What, a waste basket? Oh, no, Mr. Noodle.
That's a trash can. Trash can is for garbage.
You can't mail a letter that way.
You need a mailbox.
You need to find the mailbox, Mr. Noodle. Yeah, go and find the mailbox.
Yay, he found one. Wow, he's strong.
You need to mail the letter in the mailbox. Mail it in the mail...
No!
That's under the mailbox.
You need to put it inside the mailbox.
In.
No, that's on top of the mailbox.
Not on the mailbox, in the mailbox.
Pull the handle to open it. It's in the front.
You can do it.
There's the handle.
Now put the letter in there. Put it in.
Now put it in the mailbox. Yeah!
Yeah, that's it. Put it in.
Put it...
No, you have to let go of the letter.
No, Mr. Noodle.
You need to put it inside, Mr. Noodle.
Now put it in.
Let it go.
Yay, Mr. Noodle, you did it!
What's happening?
What's going on with the mailbox?
It's alive.
Oh, be careful. Mr. Noodle, what are you doing?
Oh, he's taking off.
Oh, it's airmail. Oh,
Dorothy. This is how I mail a birthday card to my grandmother. First, I put the letter in the envelope. Then I lick it closed. After that, I put the stamp on the envelope and put it in the mailbox. See, I put the flag up so the mail carrier knows there's mail inside. That's it, Dorothy.
Oh, thank you, everybody. Oh, and thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Hello, baby. Hi. Baby, how do you mail a letter? Oh, thank you, baby. And now, Elmo has a question for you. How many stamps are in a stamp stampede? Let's count them and see. Stamps! Stamps, I'll get you out.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Oh, seven stamps. And one very big package. Yeah. Where you going, package? Wow, smart stamps. Must be special delivery. Cool, great counting, everybody. But Elmo hopes Elmo gets more mail soon. Oh, yay!
Elmo has mail.
Elmo's got email. That's another
Elmo
kind of mail. Oh, computer.
Elmo has mail.
Computer,
Elmo
stop.
Mail.
Come back, computer.
Elmo has mail. Elmo
computer.
Has mail.
Elmo's going to get computer. Mail. Computer.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Stop, stop, computer.
Elmo has mail.
Good computer. Okay, mouse. Oh, Elmo's got email from his friend Big Bird.
Hi, Elmo. Say hello, Radar. I'm checking my mailbox to see if I got any mail. Oh, look. It's for you, Radar. It's a postcard. And guess who it's from? Me! And it says, Dear Radar, wish you were here. Oh, you are here. Love, Big Bird. He just loves getting mail.
Thanks for the email delivery, computer. Radar is so lucky. He got a postcard from Big Bird in the mail. What else can we get in the mail? Let's find out. Oh, open up drawer. Oh, that was easy. Can you get an ice cream cone in the mail?
No.
No,
it would melt.
Oh, messy. Can you get a tiger in the mail?
No.
No. But you can get a postcard from India where tigers live. Can you get a birthday cake in the mail?
No.
But you can get a birthday card. Can you get cookies in the mail?
Yes.
Cowabunga! And you get box too. I'm not for boxing. Me love postal service.
Thanks, Thor. Elmo loves getting mail as much as Cookie Monster. And Elmo's friend Jennifer likes sending it. Oh, she sent out her birthday invitations, and she told Elmo all about it. Oh, let's watch, Troy.
I'm having a birthday party soon. And I made my own birthday invitations to send to my friends. I put them in envelopes. I even decorated the envelopes myself. My mom helped me write the addresses of where my friends live. Then, all I needed were stamps. My mom took me to the post office to buy some. We waited in line. When it was our turn, I got to pick out the kindest stamps I wanted. There are lots of different kinds. I picked the ones with flowers on them. They were really pretty. Then I put the stamps on the envelopes. And then I put the invitations in the mailbox. I hope my friends get the invitations. And I really hope they can come to my party. Wait till they see the great decorations I'm making.
Oh, thanks for the invitation, Jennifer. Boy, Elmo really likes it. But now, Elmo wants to find out more about mail, don't you? How can we find out more? Are you okay, TV? Yeah, Elmo knows we can watch the Mail Channel. Are you sure you're okay, TV? Okay, turn yourself on.
The Mail Channel, where you can get mail 24 hours a day. We deliver. And now on the Mail Channel, the story of a letter.
Once upon a time, yesterday, little Billy Postmeyer wrote a letter to his grandma in Toledo. And guess who that letter was?
That's right, yours truly, me.
And then it happened, what every letter dreams of. Little Billy put a stamp on me. That tickles. And then he mailed me.
Whoa!
My journey had begun. Inside the mailbox, there were lots of other letters and packages going to places all over the world.
I'm going to the North Pole.
I'm going to South America.
Wow.
And where are you going, Junior?
I'm going to Grandma's house.
Wow. Lucky you.
All of a sudden, the mailbox opened. Grandma, is that you?
Nah, that's the letter carrier. He's gonna take us to the post office.
Before I could say postage due, I was sorted.
Whoa! The next thing I knew, I was on an airplane to Toledo.
Hey, I'm supposed to be going first class.
I thought I'd never get to Grandma's house. But before I could say return to sender, the plane landed in Toledo. And later, another letter carrier delivered me to Grandma's mailbox. Grandma, is that you?
A letter from Billy.
Boy, Grandma sure was glad to get me. And that's my story. Being a letter is very rewarding.
Coming up next on the Mail Channel, The Scarlet Letter, followed by Lady and the Stamp.
Oh, thanks, Stevie. Now Elmo really wants to know more about mail, don't you? But how can we find out more?
Hey! Want to talk to a mailbox?
A mailbox, yeah!
No one knows more about mail than I do. I get all kinds of mail.
Really? What kinds?
Oh, packages, magazines, letters, invitations. Oh, boy, I just can't get enough. Yum, yum.
Wow. Well, what kind of mail does mailbox like best?
Junk mail! Oh, boy, you got anything to mail?
No, not right now.
Oh, that's too bad, because if you did, you would put it right in here.
Oh, yes, Elmo sees.
And then the letter carrier would come and take it out of here. And that's one way mail gets from one place to another. Another way mail gets from one place to another is by airplane.
Oh, look,
At long last, I can finally feather my nest. Thank you.
You're welcome.
And that foul mail gets from one place to another.
Thanks, Mailbox. Wow. Elmo really loves mail. Oh, and Dorothy does, too. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the mail song. Here
Ooh.
We go. Yeah.
May I sing?
Oh, sure.
Mail, mail, mail. Mail, mail, mail. Mail, 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 mail. Mail, mail, mail. Mail, mail, mail. Mail, 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 mail.
Say goodbye, Mailbox.
Oh, to whom it may concern, goodbye, and I mean it sincerely.
Say goodbye, Dorothy. Oh, don't forget to drop out.
Jumping.
Go ahead, Mr. Noodle. Jump over the hurdle.
He's warming up.
He's getting ready.
No.
Not that way.
Not under the hurdle.
That's under, Mr. Noodle.
You gotta go over the hurdle.
Yeah, over.
Mr. Noodle needs to jump.
The way you did it with Elmo.
Yeah, Mr. Noodle remembers.
Try it again.
Now he's got it.
Yeah, just jump over.
No.
That's not it. You didn't jump over.
You jumped around, Mr. Noodle.
To jump over Mr. Noodle's feet and body had to go above the hurdle.
Above the hurdle.
That's right, Mr. Noodle. Over the hurdle. Now jump over it.
Okay, now he's got it.
Warming up again.
He's getting ready.
Noodle, 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 noodle.
Whoa. It's a flip.
Yay!
He did it.
Yep, he jumped over.
Good job, Mr. Noodle.
What's he doing now?
He's going back over.
Whoa, you see that?
You go, Mr. Noodle. Wow, Mr. Noodle must love jumping over.
Oh, boy. Mr. Noodle got over that hurdle. What's that, Dorothy? Oh, Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you jump over something?
See, Dorothy? This is how I jump over a rock. See, Dorothy?
Dorothy, I use my legs to jump over this crack in the sidewalk.
Dorothy, I can bend my knees and push my legs to jump over this puddle, like this.
Oh, thanks, everybody. Oh, and thank you, too, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Hello, baby. Baby, how do you jump over something? Oh, thank you, baby. Thank you. Kiss, kiss. Kiss, 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 kiss. Kiss, kiss. Mwah! And now, Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many jumping beans are jumping? Let's count them and see.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13.
Oh, 13! 13 jumping beans!
Yes!
Oh. And one leaping lizard!
Wow!
Oh, bye, lizard! Great counting, everybody! That makes them wonder, what can jump and what can't jump? Let's find out. Oh, drawer! Oh, a jumping drawer! We can jump with drawer. Let's do it. Jump, 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 jump! Can a rope jump?
No, but you can jump rope.
Yeah! Can jacks jump?
No, but you can do jumping jacks.
That's right. Can the cat jump?
Yes!
I jump at the chance because I love to count my jumps. One jump. Two jumps. Three jumps. Four jumps.
Thanks, Troy. Almost fit.
Elmo has mail. Ooh. Elmo has mail. Elmo has
boy,
mail.
Boy, everybody's Elmo jumping today. Oh, hold still, computer. Elmo wants his email.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has
stop,
mail.
Computer.
Elmo has mail.
Thank you, computer. Oh, mouse. Oh, no. A jumping mouse. Oh, come on, mouse. Elmo wants his email. Oh, thanks, mouse. Oh, boy. Elmo's got email from Zoe.
Oh. Hey, Elmo. Ballet dancers, like me, do a lot of jumping. Look, I'll show you. Here's one kind of jump. And jump. And jump. And jump. That makes my legs really strong. And look, here's another kind of leaping jump. It's called a jeté, and it's really fun. Oh, stay right there. Whee! Whoa! I guess it's a good idea to look before you leap. Bye, Elmo!
Jump, 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 jump. Boy, Elmo loves ballet jumps. friend CJ likes all kinds of jumping. He was jumping in a jumping race, and he told Elmo all about it.
The other day at school, we had a sack race. I ran to the sacks and put one on. You have to do a lot of jumping in a sack race. Then we lined up and waited for our teacher to say go.
On your mark, get set, go!
Then we jumped as fast as we could. You can't let go of the sack or let it fall below your knees. And you have to keep both feet in the sack. Those are the rules. I'm a pretty fast jumper.
Go, go, go on.
And I won. Jumping is fun. So it's falling down. I love jumping.
Boy, CJ is a great jumper. But Elmo wants to learn even more about jumping, don't you? How can we find out even more? Yeah. We can watch the Jumping Channel on TV. Yeah, TV. TV. TV, TV. Jump to it, TV. Turn yourself on.
Welcome to the Jumping Channel. We've got the jump on everybody. Now jump with the jumping lady who's here with a hip hop and a jump song.
I'm jumping. I'm jumping here and there. I'm jumping up a stair. I'm jumping forward and back. It's time for jumping jacks. I'm jumping. I'm jumping into bed, staying one jump ahead. I'm jumping near and far. Time to jump start my car. I'm jumping. There's a high jump, the long jump, to make your legs strong jump. Jumping rope, jumping ship. I love to hop, I love to skip. I love the jump shot in basketball, and even jumping checkers, y'all. I'm jumping. Feel that zing in your step, that little spring in your step. It's lots of fun to do, and jumping's good for you too. I'm jumping, they're jumping, we're jumping, you're jumping, they're jumping.
Stay tuned for the Jump Along Cassidy Show.
Wait, TV! Elmo wants to learn even more about jumping! Oh, boy. How can we find out even more? Elmo wonders who that could be. Go on.
Want to talk to a pogo stick?
Oh, boy, we can talk to a pogo stick. Boy, it must be fun being a pogo stick.
You're jumping to conclusions. Huh? But yes, it is fun, and it's fun to jump on one, too. Get a helmet and some pads and jump on.
Okay. Yeah! Now what?
Just hold on to my handles up here at the top of me.
Oh, okay. Right here?
Uh-huh. And put your feet on my foot pads that are almost at the bottom of me.
Like that?
You got it. Then all you have to do is bend your knees and use your leg muscles and jump, almost like you're on the ground.
Ah.
My spring will help you.
Oh, is that the spring?
That's it. What are you waiting for? Let's jump.
Yeah! Oh, boy, this is fun, pogo stick.
I told you.
Boy, Elmo loves this.
Then you'd probably like some other jumping sports.
Really? Like what?
Well, how about skydiving? You jump out of a plane wearing a parachute. How great is that?
Oh, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo jumping out of a plane skydiving.
And the ski jumping is great, too. makes me want to jump for joy. Yippee! Yippee!
Boy, that was some jump.
Glad you liked it. Now I think I'll go jump in the lake.
Oh, no, no, Pogo Stick. Elmo loves jumping. So does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the jumping song. Yay! Uh-oh. Where's Piano? Piano, where are you? Oh, cool jumping piano. Jumping, 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 jump.
Oh, boy, the jumping song. May I sing, too?
Sure, jump in anytime. You, too.
Jumping, 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 jump. Jumping, 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 jump.
Say goodbye, Dorothy. Say goodbye.
Keep safe.
What do firefighters wear?
No, they don't wear armor. No.
Try again, Ms. Noodle. You can do it.
Try again.
Whoa.
Careful, Ms. Noodle.
Yay!
Yeah, that's right. That's a firefighter's uniform. Ms. Noodle is pretending to put out a fire.
What's wrong, Ms. Noodle?
But there's no water coming out.
No water?
Oh.
Where's the water?
Where's the water? Boy, those noodles are very good at getting wet. Yeah, Dorothy? Okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. What do firefighters wear to keep safe when they put out fires?
Dorothy, see these gloves? Firefighters wear them so their hands don't get burnt.
Hey, Dorothy, see this coat? This coat protects firefighters from getting wet or getting burnt. Yeah, it does feel kind of heavy. It's about 5 pounds.
Hi, Dorothy. Firefighters wear these boots when they put out fires to keep their feet from getting wet or burned.
Thank you, everybody. Oh, and thanks, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask our baby. Oh, hello, baby. Baby, what do firefighters wear to keep safe when they put out fires? Oh, yeah, a helmet to keep their heads from getting hurt. Oh, thank you, baby. Now, where was Elmo? Oh, yeah. And now, Elmo has a question for you. How many firefighters are in this fire truck? Let's count them and see. Fire truck!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
12 firefighters in a fire truck! Boy. And one big elephant hose. Oh, great counting, everybody. And now...
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Hold it. Hold it. Slow down, computer. Where's the fire?
Elmo has mail.
Hey, no. Stop, computer.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Computer, where are you? Computer,
Elmo has mail.
Stop.
Elmo has mail.
At last, Elmo can get his email. Oh boy, Elmo got email from his friend Oscar.
Hey, Elmo, since I don't help whenever I can, this email is not about firefighters. It's about the toast I'm making. It's gonna be just the way I like it. Burnt. Yum.
Trash can on fire!
Stand back, please, sir.
Okay, we got a hot trash can here.
Hey.
Oh, don't touch the can, please, sir. You might get burned.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Turn on the water.
Turn the water.
Turn it on the water. Okay, the fire's out.
Okay, it's safe now, sir.
Yeah.
You can return to your trash can. Mm-hmm.
What's the big idea?
Have a nice day.
You ruined my burnt toast. Now it's all wet and soggy. Wet and soggy burnt toast? Delicious. And that's my email about burnt toast, Elmo. Hey, wait a minute. It was about firefighters too, wasn't it? Oh, phooey.
Thanks for the email, computer. Wow. Hot trash cans can burn you. Let's find out what else can burn you. Oh, drawer. There you are. Drawer's not hot. It won't burn down, Mom. Okay, drawer, open up. No, open up, drawer. No. Stay. Don't come with Elmo. Just open up, please. Oh, boy. Drawer's supposed to open.
the candles on the birthday cake can.
Blow them out quick! Very good! Can stoves burn you?
Yes. Don't touch stoves.
Can bowls burn you?
No.
Unless there's hot porridge in them.
Don't touch it, baby bear.
Come on, porridge, get cool.
I'll help. I'll huff and I'll puff.
Not me, the porridge!
Ooh, porridge.
That was great. But now, Elmo wants to learn more about firefighters, don't you? How can we find out more? Oh, look! The TV is practicing how to get low. And go! Wait! Come back, TV! Elmo wants to see the firefighter channel. Good, now turn yourself on.
The Firefighters Channel. All firefighters all the time. The channel that's really hot. Today, Mike, the firefighting dog.
One day, Mike, the firefighting dog, was eating his dinner in his firehouse when all of a sudden, the fire alarm sounded. That meant there was a fire to fight. Mike slid down the fire pole and in a jiffy put on his special firefighting clothes to protect him from the fire. And his helmet to keep his head from getting hurt. Then he rushed to the fire. When he got to the fire, he heard barking coming from inside the house. So Mike put on his air tank and mask to keep from breathing in smoke and went into the burning house. He pulled a young pup from the flames and then put out the fire. It was all in a day's work for Mike, the firefighting dog. The end. Or is it?
Look, Mikey's dreaming again.
Dreaming about chasing cats, Mikey?
Time to go fight a fire.
Watch the firehouse for us, Mikey.
Now it's the end.
Coming up next on the Firefighters Channel, The Flaming of the Shrew.
Starring Carol Burnett.
Thanks, TV. But wait, TV. Elmo wants to know more. Oh, no. TV is just practicing. But Elmo still wants to know more about firefighters. How can we find out more? Who could that be? Come in.
Want to talk to a firefighter?
Oh, boy. Elmo can talk to his friend, Firefighter Richard. Yay!
Don't forget us.
Oh, yeah. Elmo can talk to everybody.
So what do you want to know, Elmo?
Well, Elmo thinks fires are scary.
They are scary.
Oh, yeah. Very scary.
Well, is it scary being a firefighter?
Sure.
Oh, yeah, sure. Very scary.
But I take care of myself, so it's okay. I wear these special clothes that help keep me safe.
Oh, yeah, special clothes.
Elmo knows all about the boots and the coat and the helmet.
And I'm part of a team of firefighters. We work together and help keep each other safe.
Oh, a team. Oh, like a soccer team?
Yeah, sort of.
Oh, yeah, we're a team. We're buddies. Hi, buddy.
Hi.
Oh, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a firefighter.
Oh, yeah, firefighter.
Yeah. Elmo is ready to fight a fire.
Firefighters don't only fight fires.
Really?
We also help animals.
Meow. Oh, a kitty needs help. To the storm, Justin! Whee!
Firefighters help people who get hurt, too.
Firefighter Elmo will help. Much better. Thanks, Firefighter Elmo. just doing Firefighter Elmo's job. Firefighter Richard must really like being a firefighter.
I wouldn't want to do anything else.
Oh yeah. Nothing else.
Well, I better get going. It's time for me to go home and cook dinner for my kids.
Firefighter Richard is a daddy, too? Wow! Firefighters are amazing!
Oh yeah! Amazing!
I'll see you later.
Oh. Bye-bye, buddy!
Bye, Firefighter Richard! Thanks! Elmo really loves firefighters. So does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the firefighter song. Yay!
Yay! Yay!
Unusual watermelon of them all.
Come on, Repair Monster.